What's going on, everybody? Another episode of 4x4 Camping and Adventures. And in today's episode, without further ado, I'm going to show you how to install a brand new radiator in your Mitsubishi Triton. So let's get into it. Tip I can give you is this piece here. You need to remove this before you remove the actual shroud. So it just pops out, and there's this piece here that pops in the bottom. Before you remove the shroud and all that kind of stuff, just pop this out. That'll remove, and then this piece will go straight up. Alright, so the actual next step is to purge all the air from the system. So the best way of doing this, if you live on a hill, that's perfect, because what you're actually going to do is push all the air to the back of the system when you fill it up back with the coolant. So before you do that, do a radiator flush, all that kind of stuff, get it all cleaned out so you're putting a nice fresh new coolant in. The mix ratio for these cars, for a Mitsubishi Triton, is 50-50. They take about 8.6 litres. And what you want to do, as I said, is park it on a hill, put it on some stands or whatever you can just to get that front end up. And then obviously you're going to push all the air to the back of the system. Now from here, you want to get the car to operating temperature. So these are about 86 to 88 degrees. When they get to operating temperature, obviously they're going to release all the air that's in the system throughout the whole process. So it normally takes about probably half an hour to an hour, but air can be in there for days, if you know what I mean. So some people have said that you can release the cap and sort of have the cap halfway on to continue to release the air along, you know, just as you're driving around normally. So depending how you want to do it, depending on how much air is in the system. When I did mine, I left her for about 15 minutes and didn't get any air bubbles, so I was pretty happy with that. The main thing is just making sure that you haven't got big air blocks. So you don't want big air blocks, because they can actually make heat spots on your engine, and that can cause damage down the track, because that section of the engine isn't actually getting cooled properly. So from there, once you've, as I said, filtered the system and taken all the air out of the system, You're ready to rock and roll, take it for a maiden voyage, drive around, get it up to 110, give it a blast down the highway, make sure nothing's going crazy, make sure the temperatures don't go, you know, crazy high, you know, above what they normally run at, and mine normally runs about 88 degrees. So that's how you do a full radiator change in these cars. They're quite easy to do. I think it was a 12 mil and a 10 mil spanner is all I needed, and a socket. And a screwdriver to take off the clamps. If you've got the stock Triton, you probably have to get a pair of pliers to take off the original clamps that come with these cars, because they're like the claw type clamps. And then from there, you're pretty much ready to rock and roll. They are so easy to do. So yeah, save yourself a couple of bucks and do it yourself. But just make sure you bleed out the system properly and you'll be all good. But that has been another episode of 4x4 Camping and Adventures. Please like and subscribe. Comment down below if you like this video. If I don't see you out in the tracks and trails, I might even see you in the next video. And if I don't see you out in the next video, I shall see you later. Bye.